Diabetes mellitus occurs when the body doesn't produce adequate amounts of insulin or becomes less responsive to insulin. Insulin is a hormone made by the pancreas with many functions, but its main purpose is to tell cells to take up glucose from the bloodstream. Glucose is the main energy source for the body's cells, and without adequate insulin or the inability to properly respond to insulin, glucose doesn't get taken up properly. Thus, blood glucose levels increase in diabetes mellitus, leading to high blood sugar levels or hyperglycemia. Hyperglycemia leads to sugar spilling over into urine, resulting in increased urination. The word mellitus in diabetes mellitus means honeysweet in Latin and differentiates this type of diabetes from a rare disease called diabetes insipidus, which has similar signs but doesn't result in sugar or glucose in the urine. To compensate for the increased water loss with the additional urination, thirst also increases. Without treatment of diabetes mellitus, the body relies on fat for energy, resulting in the production of toxic acids known as ketones. Ketones can also spill over into the urine. Left untreated, diabetic ketoacidosis can lead to coma and death. Insulin overdose can also be dangerous as it can lead to a very low blood glucose level or severe hypoglycemia. The greatest risk of insulin overdose is when a pet has not eaten or has not eaten well and still is given their full insulin dose. This risk is more common in pets as blood glucose is not typically measured to enable adjustments in the insulin dose given. Thus, changes in the diet or food may not be made in newly diagnosed type 1 diabetics to make sure that the food that is normally fed is readily eaten and insulin overdose is less likely. In humans, many of the long-term effects of hyperglycemia and poor glucose control, such as kidney failure, are not recognized in pets. Even with good control, some serious conditions are unfortunately expected to develop in pets, like blindness from cataracts in dogs. Therefore, dietary therapy in pets is mainly designed to reduce the likelihood of pets being so poorly controlled as to be at risk of life-threatening situations like diabetic ketoacidosis, especially in the dog, and in the cat to also potentially eliminate the need for insulin injections. Pets with diabetes mellitus drink more water and urinate more than normal, referred to as polydipsia and polyuria, or PUPD. PUPD, coupled with unintended weight loss, raises the concern that a pet might have diabetes mellitus. The diagnosis of diabetes mellitus relies typically on measuring blood glucose and looking for glucose and possibly ketones in the urine. Hyperglycemia can occur with stress, especially in the cat, such as during a visit to the veterinarian, so the presence of glucose in the urine, along with more advanced tests like measuring fructosamine, can give a better sense of the typical blood glucose levels. If blood glucose levels are high, not due to stress in the cat, along with glucose in the urine, a diagnosis of diabetes mellitus is made. All dogs with diabetes mellitus need insulin injections for the rest of their lives, as dogs only develop type 1, also known as insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus. Cats may have type 1 or type 2, also known as non-insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus. Therefore, they may need insulin injections or just oral medications, especially if coupled with loss of any extra body weight. Losing extra body weight can potentially cause insulin-dependent diabetic cats to no longer need injections of insulin. This is because weight loss can make the body more sensitive to insulin, which may mean the insulin made solely by the body is enough to get an appropriate uptake of glucose. For a more comprehensive discussion on how to nutritionally manage weight, please see the weight management video in this series. Key strategies discussed in that video include feeding less calories than are needed, nutrient enhancement, energy density reduction, caloric distribution modifications, increased feeding frequency and treating, and providing supplemental compounds, especially L-carnitine. In the dog, weight loss will not eliminate the need for insulin injections, but may reduce the needed dose as well as help with overall blood glucose level or glycemic control. All other nutritional therapy strategies are for fine-tuning of glycemic control and may not be tried, especially if they may lead to reduced appetite. Dietary fiber can help reduce the absorption and rate of absorption of glucose from food. Muting or slowing glucose absorption can lead to better glycemic control. Unfortunately, high dietary fiber may not be as palatable to some pets and/or may not be tolerated. Some foods inherently have a higher fiber content, like legumes, and may be used for this express purpose, or more concentrated fiber may be supplemented into the diet. Dietary fiber has an effect on stool volume and quality. Many pets have improved stool quality with higher dietary fiber, and fermentable fiber or prebiotics may be beneficial to GI flora or microbiota. At the same time, the occasional pet may not tolerate very high dietary fiber levels, and adjustments in amount may be needed based solely on stool quality in those cases. Generally, mixed fiber sources that come from natural sources like psyllium seed husk or legumes, as well as more purified insoluble fiber sources like cellulose, are better tolerated than just purified soluble fibers like from gum. Glycemic index is a measure of how quickly blood glucose rises following consumption of a particular amount of food in humans. The lower the glycemic index, the less the food causes a rise in blood glucose. As different foods have different carbohydrate levels, some differences in glycemic index are largely related to the carbohydrate content of the food. Much of the difference can also be attributed to the fiber content of the food. For example, legumes that are higher in protein and thus lower in carbohydrate, and also higher in dietary fiber than white rice, not surprisingly have a lower glycemic index than white rice. Therefore, certain carbohydrate sources may be preferentially used in pet food appropriate for the nutritional management of diabetes mellitus. There is some overlap in folks' minds with glycemic index and the term complex carbohydrate. Starch is a complex carbohydrate, meaning that it is made up of long chains of molecularly linked glucose. This means that it takes longer to digest and release the glucose or sugar the complex carbohydrate contains compared to eating a food rich in simpler sugars like fruit. Fortunately, most pets do not consume a great deal of foods really rich in simple sugars like granulated sugar, syrups, candy, or juice. In diabetic pets, simple sugars should be avoided and fruits should be carefully selected if blood glucose control has been challenging. Reducing the amount of total dietary carbohydrate may also be helpful in managing diabetic pets, as eating less dietary carbohydrate reduces the total amount of glucose that is digested and is available to raise the blood glucose level. In cats, there is some evidence that weight loss and possibly a low-carbohydrate diet may revert a diabetic cat into not needing insulin injections. This is an active area of research, but if tolerated, a diet that is lower in carbohydrate and higher in protein and/or fat may be indicated. Not all cats will tolerate such a diet, so higher fiber or less energy-dense foods that are high in carbohydrate may also be suggested to induce weight loss. Dietary therapy in diabetic pets is often fine-tuning or tried when other medical therapies have not resulted in good glycemic control. Glycemic control may be assessed with an all-day blood glucose curve or measuring fructosamine, which gives one a sense of the average level of control over several weeks. Thirst and urination at home may also be monitored and noted. Occasionally, a veterinarian may train one to measure a pet's blood glucose level at home. Dietary therapy may be instituted and adjusted based on glycemic control, and if weight loss is needed, to achieve an ideal body condition in diabetic pets. If glycemic control is not improved with diet modifications, then a normal maintenance food or a food appropriate for any other concurrent conditions may be fed. With the right combination of medical and dietary treatments, pets can often live quite comfortably with diabetes mellitus.